At the time of this video, there's no tool available to edit the YAD files yet. DexEffects, please add YAD editing, CodeWalker.
My prayers have been answered. On February 6th, DexEffects added YAD XML conversion to CodeWalker, and this update allowed me to modify YAD files in order to fix the issues I had with my custom add-on ped showcased in the previous video. If you haven't seen it, I recommend you watch that video before this one. In this video, I will go through fixing the issues I encountered with my custom ped, as well as adding new features with the power of YAD editing. Let's start by fixing those issues. In the last video, I showcased two main issues with my ped. First was the lack of breast support, and the second was the lack of hair scaling support, i.e. shrinking the ponytail when a motorcycle helmet was equipped. There is, however, a third issue that I didn't address. Like Wade's example from part 1, the hip bones were inactive. The reason I didn't illustrate the issue is because I made a temporary solution by mixing the weights from the hip to the thighs. The thigh bones are still active, so mixing the hip's weight with it was the only workaround. However, with YAD editing support now available, I'll fix this issue the proper way. For starters, I'll be copying all the content from PM1 YAD to my own YAD file. I'll name my YAD file NC Charlotte CS YAD. I also changed the expression dictionary name value from PM1 to NC Charlotte CS in the APM XML file. Now the game will use my custom expression dictionary file instead of Franklin's. Inside my YAD file, I removed all components that are not useful to my ped. For example, my ped only contains upper 000U and upper 001U. But the YAD file contains data for upper 025U, which does not exist in my YDD. Therefore, I removed it. I also renamed the components if their prop mass did not match mine. An example is lower 000R inside the YAD file, but my YDD file uses lower 000U, thus renaming the component from lower 000R to lower 000U. With the unnecessary components gone, it's a good time to go through some of the remaining items. The first noticeable item is face init expression. This is responsible for having your character open their mouth when speech is played. Without this, the mouth will remain shut. Next is the head component. This block is responsible for enabling facial animation. Without this, your ped will remain with a blank stare. Now with that out the way, let's dive deep into the basics of editing an expression dictionary file. The order of items in your expression dictionary file has to match your YDD file. Otherwise, the changes you made won't work. My YDD file has lower 001U as the first component. If you place another component before it in your YDD file, you will break the changes you made for the lower 001U component. Just a heads up. Luckily, Solimm's Blender plugin automatically sorts the order of components when you export your ped. I also added face init expression as a drawable to my rig. It only exists to see what order it's in my YDD after export. That way, I know where to place it in my YED file. It's important to mention that not all components from your YDD file have to be added to the YED file. Some components will do just fine even if the component doesn't exist in the YED file. In my case, the hip bones were inactive in the lower 000U component, so let's fix that first. I copied the lower 000R component from PM1 YED, then pasted it and renamed it to lower 000U. The name of the components you add has to match the name and order in the YDD file. Just like that, the hip bones are already working. Nice. Well, let's focus on getting the breasts to bounce. Fortunately, those are also an easy fix. If you take a look at the rig on Blender, the breastbone has a bone tag. A bone tag is an identifier that will be used in the YAD file. The left breast has a bone tag of 64654, and the right breast has a bone tag of 34911. Now remember these values because they will play a role later. Next, if we open the ambient YAD file, search for the term breasts expression. Collapse the bone tracks tag and look inside the instructions tag inside the streams tag. Inside, you will find two items with jiggle properties. Copy both and paste it to your instructions tag in your desired upper component. In my case, it's upper 000U. Remember the bone tag values mentioned earlier? As you can see, the jiggle item has a bone tag property. These values match the bone ID in my rig. Just like that, boopa be boppin'. Lastly, let's get the hair scaling bone to work. The PM1 YAD file contained the hair 000R component, but did not feature the hair scale support I needed. So I took the hair 000R component from PM0 YAD instead, pasted it to my YAD file, and renamed it to hair 000U in order to match the component in the YDD file. Again, friendly reminder, the order of the hair component has to match your YDD file. In my case, the hair component is in the last order, therefore it's placed last in my YDD file. And voila, HeroScale support is now active. And there you have it. The three main issues I have with my custom pet have been resolved. But why stop here? While I was researching how expression dictionary files work, I learned you can create your own custom bones and assign constructors to them. As you can see in the video, I added the same breast jiggle effect to my pet's posterior. I also added spring effect to the front bangs of her hairstyle, simulating physics. Lastly, I noticed the female multiplayer model's height adjusts when certain heels or sneakers are being equipped and added that same feature to my custom pet. In Blender, I added two new bones in the proximity of her butt and parented them to the scale pelvis bone. When you're creating your bones, you can name them whatever you want. The important part is the bone tag value. That value will play a role in the YED file. First, make sure to insert a custom bone tag value that isn't used by another bone in your rig. In my case, I took the breast bone tag value and added 1 to it. So in my rig, I have a left butt bone named SPRL butt with a bone tag value of 64655. The value 64655 is not used by another bone, making it available for my custom bone. The name of the other bone is called SPRR butt with a bone tag value of 34912. It's also important to add the following tags to your bones: rotation X, Y, and Z, and translation X, Y, and Z. With the bones added, now it's time to weight paint the mesh to the new bones. And bam, there you have it. Now let's export the model. When you export your pet with the new bones included, make sure to update your YFT file based on your new YDD file. Otherwise, you will cause a mismatch between your YDD and YFT file. Now it's time to register your new bones in the YDD file. The component that will use the new bones is lower000u, so let's start by registering the new bones. As you can see, I have added 4 new items, 2 for each butt, with different track and flags values. Remember the bone tag values mentioned earlier? This is where I'll insert my custom values. 64655 is left butt, and 34912 is right butt. The only thing we need to do is give them instructions, i.e. tell the game what to do with them. Still inside the lower000u component, navigate to streams and then the instructions tag. Inside, paste the jiggle item block. You can copy it for breast expression inside the ambient YED. Again, make sure to change the bone tag value to your custom value. In my case, it's 64655 and 34912. That should be it. Your newly created bone should now have a jiggle effect on the butt. The cool thing is, you can add a jiggle effect to anything you can imagine, so why not also add it to the hair? Following the same principles we did with the butt, I added 2 new bones to each bang. The left bang is named SPRL Bangs Root with a bone tag value of 64656, and the right one is named SPRR Bangs Root with a bone tag value of 34914. Weight paint the hair bangs to their corresponding bones and export your model again. Also make sure to update your YFT again so it too contains your new bones. Inside the YED file, locate the hair000u component and register the new bones the same way you did with the butt bones, but with a new bone tag value, of course. For hairs, I changed the values for the vector03 and vector04 property. To my understanding, vector03 controls the delay of spring motion when movement begins, and vector04 controls the amount of wobble when movement has stopped. You can freely experiment with other properties to suit your desired effect. Other than that, the hair now has an illusion of physics. Let's add the capability to change the pet height when certain footwear is equipped. Currently, my custom pet wears heels, but I want to have the feature of reduced height when my character is wearing a sneaker, for instance. Adding this feature is pretty simple. Open the ambient YED file, search for MP heels expression, copy the whole block, and paste it in as the feet component. In my case, it's the feet000u component. If I follow the component order of my YDD file, the copied block should be pasted below the face init expression block. After, rename MP heels expression to feet000u. Now it's active in my YED file, but I'm not done yet because I have to activate it for my pet in the pet metadata. Inside the APM XML file, locate the creature metadata name and change the value to MP creature metadata. This value enables hair scaling and adjustable height for your components. In my example, my pet has an extra feet component, which is a simple barefoot mesh. However, as you can see, she's floating. With the changes I just made, I can open up the pet metadata file or YMT file with a tool called YMT Editor. Shout out to Gizhebek for creating this tool. And sorry if I butchered your name. Link in the description. When locating the desired feet component, click the View Component Properties button and this field will show. Pay attention to the row with hash 07AE529D label on it. It has 5 numeric values for you to enter. The only numeric value you're going to change is the one to the far right. Here you can add a higher value or a negative value. In my case, my ped was floating in the air, so I had to add a negative number in order to get her closer to the ground. And that's it! When you add new feet components in order to change the height of your character, you don't have to update your YAD file. Simply change the height by editing the numeric value in your YMT file instead. Now before I end this video, I want to give a huge thanks to DexEffex for adding YAD support for CodeWalker. Without his work, this video or YAD editing in general wouldn't be possible. You can follow their Discord server for future updates. When joining the server, please do yourself a favor and go to the rules page and read the rules before you start posting. Thank you. I also want to give a shout out to the Solemns community for their work on adding GTA 5 modding support for Blender. You can also follow their Discord server for future updates in regard to the Solemns Blender plugin. Again, when joining, please read the rules. Anyway, that's it for me. Stay safe out there and peace out.